Hi friends, welcome back to CADable. This is Engineer Ibrahim Omer, and today we'll create the custom weldment profile in Solidworks. I am using Solidworks 2020, and if you are using a below version or a future version, you can still follow this tutorial. Okay, so let's first create the custom profile. I'll go to a new and select part and select OK. And now we are in Solidworks interface. So first of all, as usual, I will change my background. And you can see that I'm using MMGS. Okay, so first create the weldment profile. Let's go to your front plane, select sketch, and I will create the custom profile. So let's say I will start from a line, and I will create one line here, and I will create a midpoint line here. Okay, let's dimension these. Let's go to your smart dimension, and let's say this dimension is maybe 70 millimeters. And let's say this dimension is 50 millimeters. Okay, and let's go to your offset entities, and offset distance, let's say it would be 3 millimeters. And first I will select this line, and then I will select this line, and here I will be using this option bidirectional, so that we have offset line in the both directions. Okay, you can see a preview here. Also, I will check this box, cap ends, not arcs but lines. Okay, and select okay. Now I will trim the unnecessary portion. Let's go to your trim entities. First I will trim this line, then I will trim this portion and this portion, and now you can see your preview. So we are done with this sketch, although this sketch is not fully defined, but this sketch will work for us. So let's exit this sketch. And now I will use this profile as my weldment profile. So first I have to save this profile. Basically we have to find the file location so that we could save this file in that directory. So we have to find the directory for weldment profiles. So for this, just go to your options, and I'll go to your file locations. And now I will search for weldment profile. So I will scroll this to maybe, let's say here, you can see that weldment profile, just click here. And now you can see the directory D, Solidworks, language, English, and weldment profiles. Okay. So let's save this custom profile. You have to select your sketch or your profile before saving as library feature part. So select this profile, and I'll go to here, save as, and I will change this from solid part to, let's say, this option library feature part. And now I have to change this directory. Let's go to here D volume, and I will search for Solidworks. Just double click it. I'll go to here language, English, and weldment profile. And here you can see that I have already created this folder, CADable custom profiles. When you find this in your PC, so you could find only NC inch or ISO as default Solidworks weldment profile. So I will create another folder. I'll go to a new, and I will make another folder, and I will create a new folder as custom profiles. Okay, custom profiles, and just double click it, and I will create another folder. And let's say this folder name is T section, okay, because it is a T section profile. And just double click again, and here I will change its name to, let's say, 50 by 70, okay, or 70 by 50. And library feature part, and I will save this. Okay, and now you can see that this profile is saved in that SolidWorks directory. When I will be calling this structural member, so I could find this profile. Okay, so let's go to here new, and select part and select OK. And now I will create a profile of a frame, and then I will use that profile in my frame. Okay, so let's click this box, weldment, and let's go to a sketch, and I will create a 3D sketch. Let's go to a line command. Let's say I will create one line here, one line here and one line here. Okay, just right click, rotate, and now I will create a very basic structure, and I have to change my direction. It would be in the let's say YZ plane. Okay, so press tab. Now I can create this dimension. Okay, press tab again and press tab again. And now I have to join this to this one, but you can see that this is not the correct direction or correct plane. So press tab so that I could change this plane to YZ. And now I will join this to here. Okay, I will select this line, I will select this line and this line, and I will make them equal. Okay, and these lines would also be equal. You can see that these lines are in X axis. And let's say I will dimension this. Let's say this one is maybe 200, and let's say this dimension is let's say 800, and let's say this dimension is 600. Okay, you can see that this is not fully defined, and just select this one, and this would be in Z axis. Okay, so select this line and make them make along Z, and now you can see that this is fully defined. Okay, so my structure is ready, and now I can use my weldment profile. Let's change this dimension to maybe 350. It is quite small. Okay, so I will press exit. Now I will use that profile in my structure. Let's use this profile in this structure. So I'll go to here, weldments. First I will click this option, rebuild, and let's go to here, weldment structural member, and I will use this option, custom profiles. Type is T section and size is 70 by 50. Okay, that we have just created. And now I will select this one, and I will select this one, I will select this one, and I will select this one. Okay, so this is let's say group one or same group. For creating these legs, I have to change my group. So select this option, new group, and I will select this one, this one, this one, and this one. And you can play with all these parameters and select OK. And now you can see that our frame is ready, and I can hide this sketch. And here you can see that your custom weldment profile. Just go to your section, and here you can see that your T section profile is created. Okay, so that's how you create custom profiles in SolidWorks. So that's it for today's tutorial. I hope you like it, and if you have any questions, any queries related to this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting projects. Thank you.